Welcome to Tech Manitoba's digital series called Connected. Tech Manitoba is a nonprofit organization dedicated to champion and empower Manitoba's tech sector. The content in these episodes is focused on the Windows-based personal computers provided by the Computers for Schools program. Computers for Schools is a nonprofit organization that refurbishes donated computers for new users. This series of episodes will take you through basic setup and use of your computer, connection to the internet, and use of some common internet services. Please note that your computer might not look exactly like the examples in the videos, but we'll do our best to demonstrate options that will work for your situation. The information provided can be applied to almost any computer running the Microsoft Windows operating system. We'll explain this topic and many more in these videos. By the end, you should be able to understand some new terms and use the most common programs on your computer. My name's Lucille, and I'll be your guide on this journey. So now, let's get to learning. You should have received a printed booklet along with your computer. That booklet will show you the parts and how to connect the computer together. This first episode will review those steps and ensure that everything's correct. If you don't have the booklet, that's okay. Just follow along with the video. The first thing is to consider where you're going to place your computer. You need a desk or a tabletop with a chair that's appropriate height. You'll likely want to hook up your computer to the internet later, and this type of desktop computer uses a cable, it's not wireless. So you'll also need two available electrical outlets for the computer and the monitor. If you have a place in your home that has an existing internet gateway box or internet cable, then you want to be close to that. If you're going to be calling an internet service provider to set up a new connection for you, well then it can be almost anywhere in your home because they'll bring the cable to your computer. Let's look at the parts and what they do. First item we'll look at is the monitor. This is a bit like a television screen and it's used to see information and images and video from your computer. This is how the computer provides information to you, the user. The next part is the actual computer, or what's called the CPU. That stands for Central Processing Unit. This is where all the information and the software are stored. Software refers to the programs that run on your computer and perform different tasks. Hardware refers to the actual computer parts that you can see and you can touch. This is a keyboard, which we use to key in information or input data. It lets you, the user, enter information into your computer. And then you have a mouse. It's used to move a mouse pointer around and make choices by clicking it. This makes moving around and using the computer much easier. And they called it a mouse because it kind of looks like one. You may have also received a set of headphones. These are optional. You would use these if your computer doesn't have built-in speakers, or if you didn't want the sounds from your computer to disturb others in your home, or if it's too loud in the background and you want to hear only your computer. If you have other headphones, you can use them as long as the connection is the same. You'll notice that this CPU is flat. Some computers you might have seen are tall and stand vertically, and they call those towers. Tower CPUs are the same, but they just stand differently on your desk or underneath it. While we're here, let's look at some other features. In the back, this is the area where we find the fan. CPUs hate heat. This fan runs continuously when your computer is on to keep all the components inside cool. So never place anything against the fan that will block the airflow. Dust, dog, and cat hair will all get sucked up inside it. So keep the area back there clean so your computer will last you a long time. On the back of the computer, you'll also see several other ports and connectors. You'll notice that they're different colors and different shapes. Each connects to a different piece of hardware. Beside the light blue round port, is a musical note and an arrow showing out. This is for a speaker or for headphones. It's showing you that music will be coming out of the computer. The light green round port just below shows a musical note and an arrow indicating in, so this would be for a microphone. You'll notice if you now look at the front of your CPU, these options are there also. Often people find it easier to plug headphones in the front. Either will work, so it's up to you. You can plug your system into a wall socket, but it's preferable to use a power surge bar. This will protect your computer from any electrical shock if the power should go out or surge. All right, we're all set up. Just a few notes. Some people like to save space and they put their monitor on top of their CPU, and that's perfectly okay if you prefer this. Try to keep the monitor at eye level. If it's too high or too low, you'll place stress on your neck. Place the keyboard and the mouse at an appropriate location with support for your wrists and arms to avoid stress and injury. One important thing that I need to point out is that dirt and liquid are a computer's enemy. So try to get in the habit of not having drinks or food around your computer. Many keyboards and computers have been ruined by a spilled drink. Congratulations. We are ready to turn everything on, and I hope you found this helpful. We did introduce some new computer terms, and if you'd like to review them, just watch the video again. If you feel ready to start using the computer, please start the second video in our series, and let's get the computer started up and get to using it.